Hello, photographers. My name is Spyros Heniadis, and this is where I answer your photography questions, and we learn about photography together. And how was your weekend? Mine was wonderful, and it was kind of exhausting. I spent the entire weekend catching up on all of your emails that I haven't been able to answer for the last 4 months, and it feels really good to be caught up. But let me tell you, answering over 1,000 emails in 3 days will definitely drain your energy. And since I spent the weekend doing that, I decided that today I would take a break from our Lightroom series and share with you one of the bonus videos from my Guide to Shooting in Manual Mode video course. In this video, I'm going to show you my 3-step method for getting the shallowest depth of field possible for that beautiful out-of-focus bokeh that we all love. And if you're interested in the Guide to Shooting in Manual Mode, you can check this link out right here to learn all about it. And one last thing before we get into the video, there will be a Q&A video this Thursday, even though it's Christmas Day. So if you're chilling out with the family and you need a photography break, be sure to tune in. In this first Building the Shot bonus video, I'm going to show you how to use my 3-step method for getting shallow depth of field. The important thing to know about this 3-step method is that you use it alongside of the I am shooting method. This is not an either-or situation. It's taking one set of steps and incorporating it into another set of steps, because you always have to set your ISO, aperture, and shutter speed in order to get the exposure that you want to get. Now, the 3 steps to getting shallow depth of field start before you get into your ISO, aperture, and shutter speed settings. Step number 1 has to do with your lens. As you remember from the depth of field video, when you use your zoom lens at its most telephoto zoom, meaning the longest zoom on the lens, that effectively brings the camera closer to the subject, which makes the depth of field shallower. And as a result, I'm going to take my Pentax K3, which has the 18 to 55 millimeter kit lens on it, and I'm going to zoom that to 55 millimeters. And now step number 2 has to do with where I position the camera when I take the photograph. And when I take the photo, I'm going to be as close to the flowers as I possibly can be. The reason for that is the same reason I used the 55 millimeter zoom, because the closer the camera is to the subject, the shallower the depth of field is going to be. So steps 1 and 2 come before I even set my settings. Number 1, I have zoomed my lens all the way out to its longest zoom, in my case, 55 millimeters. Number 2, in preparing for the shot, I am getting as close to the subject as I possibly can to take this photograph. Now, if I get too close with my camera, the lens will not focus, which you can hear happening right here. So if that happens to you when you're trying to do this kind of a shot, you will need to back up a little bit, and just back up a little bit until the camera focuses. So this distance right here is as close as I can get and still get a lock in focus. So now that I've got a lock in focus, I need to set my settings. And currently, my settings are at ISO 100, aperture is at f14, and my shutter speed is 1/320th of a second. And these are just the settings that I had set the last time I used the camera. I'm going to start with the ISO, because that's number 1 when we're using the I am shooting method. And I'm going to set the ISO to 400 because of this lighting situation that we're in. It is daytime, but it's an overcast day, and here in my porch, it's not super bright. So I'm going to set my aperture to 400. And now that I've done that, I'm getting to step 3 of the depth of field method. Step 1 for depth of field was zoom the lens out as far as possible to its longest focal length. Step number 2 was get as close to the subject as possible. Step number 3 is set your aperture to the largest sized opening, which will be the smallest available aperture number possible. I'm currently at f14, and I'm going to set my aperture to f5.6. This is step 2 of I am shooting, aperture. I set my ISO to 400. Now I'm setting my aperture to f5.6, the largest available aperture I can get. Now what I'm going to do is point my camera at my subject and set my shutter speed so that my exposure indicator reads zero. Now, when I do that, I get a shutter speed of 1/20th of a second. This is step 3 of I am shooting, setting your shutter speed. But 1/20th of a second is too slow of a shutter speed for me to get a sharp photo. I know that for two reasons. First of all, 1/20th is slower than 1/30th, and 1/30th is that shutter speed where general motion starts to show up. However, I'm using this lens zoomed to 55 millimeters. So I need to use the 1/focal length rule in order to get to the shutter speed I need. That shutter speed would be 1/50th of a second or 1/60th of a second. So what I'm going to do here is set my shutter speed where I need it, which is 1/50th of a second. And now I'm going to go back up to my ISO and set my ISO so that I get an exposure reading of zero. That takes me to ISO 1000. And now that I'm set, I can take my photograph. Now this is what the photograph looks like right here. And actually, I think that this photo is a little bit too dark. This is a situation where the camera is telling me that it has the correct amount of light. The exposure indicator is reading zero, but I, as the photographer, disagree with the camera, and I think that the photograph should be brighter. So what I'm going to do to compensate for that is adjust my ISO even higher to capture more light. It was at ISO 1000, and as I look at this, it looks to be about one stop too dark for my tastes. So what I'm going to do is increase my ISO by one stop. That means I'm going to go from ISO 1000 to ISO 2000. And now I'm going to take another photograph. I've changed no other settings, and as a result, my exposure indicator is now reading +1. And now this is what that photograph looks like. And as we look at this, I like it better. It is brighter and it has more detail and more information in it. And I am happy with this shot. I'm happy because the subject that I wanted to be in focus is in focus. And I'm also happy because my depth of field in the background is nice and shallow and everything there is out of focus. So to recap, what we've done here is use the I am shooting method along with the shallow depth of field method to take the photograph that we wanted to take. We wanted a nice photo of the flowers with a blurry, shallow depth of field background. I am shooting is simple, and we've already covered that in the I am shooting video. ISO, aperture, and shutter speed. We set our settings in that order for every single shot. All we did was add the shallow depth of field method, which is three simple steps. Number one, zoom your lens out to its longest focal length. On my lens, it was 55 millimeters. Number two, when you're taking the photo, get the camera as close to the subject as is possible. And then the third step was to set your aperture to its widest available opening. When you do those three steps, you make the depth of field as shallow as it can possibly be for the subject you are photographing. All right, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I look forward to seeing your beautiful shallow depth of field photos on our Google Plus community. And if you have any questions about this method, let me know down in the comments. And don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my channel. If you really like this video, why don't you do me a favor and share with your friends? But the most important thing to do is to get out there and take some damn photos. I'll see you on Thursday for our Q&A.